Hey, what's up, Serbians here, and welcome to your online lecture series. So, welcome to Introduction to Criminology, learning it in a simple way. So, ang mga complex na bagay ay papadalain natin in order for you to understand Introduction to Criminology in much brief and concise discussion. Okay? So, for our unit overview, last episode, we've talked about the historical evolution of criminology, the emergence of criminology, and today we're gonna talk about the developing of criminological theory. Okay? Kasi we must understand that criminology doesn't limit us on the social control or law enforcement side. It is also more leaned on criminological theory, developing and understanding a social phenomenon through empirical research. Okay, so more on research din tayo dito in criminology. So, under developing criminological theory, we have four topics to be discussed. It is the science and theory, wherein alamin natin dito the basic concepts in science and theory, yung application in criminological theories, and the 2, 3, and 4 would be the application one, wherein we would understand how to create, construct, but to identify and analyze on how to create one theory or to test the theory itself. Okay, sige, simulan natin sa science and theory. So, sa science and theory, we want us to understand or we want us to have the purpose on knowing or identifying the scientific methods and theory. And dapat maintindihan din natin ng importance ng science and theory. So, it's science and theory. In here, kailangan natin ma-understand that criminology has this thing called criminological theory, wherein we would find crime as a social phenomenon. Okay, madedevelop pa rin naman natin on how criminological theory works. Okay, using syempre yung ating scientific method. Okay, dito tayo. Scientific investigation is based on empiricism. Ibig sabihin dito, empirical, magkakaroon, kailangan kasi ang ating crime as a social phenomenon, it is observable and it is measurable. Okay? In scientific or empirical study, if it isn't observable, hindi siya nakikita, at hindi naman siya na-measure, what's the point on having a scientific investigation? Okay? Ganon din sa crime as a social phenomenon. Kailangan nakikita natin yung mga bagay or mga deviant behaviors, and syempre, lalagyan natin siya ng measurement in order for us to back up with the data on the causes, or pwede sabihin natin yung mismong concept ng crime na nakita natin or deviancy. Okay? Itong epistemological frameworks per se, it would be kasi nagkakaroon tayo dito ng beliefs. Okay? In order for us to back up our theory, kailangan natin ng facts and data. Okay? As epistemological frameworks per se would be kailangan justified yung ating beliefs, not the mere fact of having our own opinion on one social phenomenon or one crime as a concept. Kaya ibig sabihin yung belief natin naka-back up siya through data, or kaya pwede rin naman yung other literature. Okay? Ang tatlong frameworks natin dito is yung objectivism, constructivism, and subjectivism. Simulan natin sa objectivism. Focus tayo dito. Okay? Sa objectivism natin, ang sinasabi, orientation of the real world outside people's consciousness. Ibig sabihin, may nakikita tayong bagay in our field na tayong nakakaintindi, and we want others to understand our point of view. Okay? May mga nakikita tayo in our field na tayong nakakaintindi, and with the help of this one, yung beliefs natin to back it up, we want them to be aware also, okay, sa mga bagay na nakikita natin through empirical research pa rin. Okay, para at least magkaroon tayo ng proof that this phenomenon or this concept really does exist. Okay, that's objectivism. May mga bagay tayong nakikita na gusto nating ibigay dun sa kanila outside consciousness ng normal social construct. Okay? Ang sinasabi naman natin constructivism, ibig sabihin this framework naman, it's a conscious of social construct, people creating their own reality. In this kind of framework, we're gonna create or we're gonna make a new concept wherein ang gusto naman natin dito is a new thing for others to understand. So si objectivism, mga hindi napapansin na gusto nating pansinin. Si constructivism is gusto nating gumawa ng panibagong konsepto at i-introduce sa tao. Okay? Ang subjectivism naman, unconscious social construct, ibig sabihin, it really does exist. It really does exist. Meron na talagang ganitong konsepto. And we don't know the explanation or yung theorem behind that. So, ang nangyayari dito sa subjectivism is we're gonna conduct an empirical research to make the unconscious conscious. Okay? Ibig sabihin kasi ng social construct, it's quite abundant within the society. Kasi diba para magkaugnay ang pag-uugali ng tao, and ang gusto natin din doon is it meron na talaga siya, kailangan lang natin siyang pagtuunan ng attention. Okay? Nabuo na siya matagal na, gusto lang natin maging aware din doon. Okay? Subjectivism, wala talaga siya. May nakita tayong bago, gusto natin introduce. Sa subjectivism, nandyan na siya, hindi lang natin napapansin in a sense, and gusto natin siyang i-emphasize that it really does exist within and it is made through the social control. Okay? Next. Yan, scientific method. Ang scientific method natin is nagsisimula siya in conceptualizing. Okay? We want to conceptualize, ito yung pinaka-thesis statement natin. Okay? Gusto natin mag-conceptualize ng isang bagay na hindi natin nakikita. Pwede objectivity, yung framework natin ng to be objectivity, yung ating subjectivity, yan, pasok na yan, pati yung constructivism natin. In order for us to have a legit na proof on our belief, scientific method is a way. Okay? Ang scientific method is a process wherein it is not a linear. Pwede siyang pabalik-balik kasi it's a trial and error stage kasi we want to discover things. But normally, it starts or it begins with the general idea. Okay, the general idea, makukuha natin siya sa mga dati or recent na theories wherein we could apply it up until now. Okay? It's either we want to prove, to correlate, or to find causal with it. Basta ang kailangan natin dito is the general idea. Pero, in other cases, they start, yung iba sa nagsisimula on literature and having the general idea, while others starts with interviews kaagad in order for them to understand the problem. Simula sila sa problem, iba nagsisimula sa pagbabasa or literature. Okay? It really depends. But this one is the standard one. Yung second natin, ito yung observation and creation of hypos. Okay? Yung first and second, pwede sila mag-interchange. Depende kay researcher. Pero ito ang pinaka-standard. Nagsimula muna sa standard general idea or general theory. Then, nagkaroon ng observation wherein nagkaroon ng creation for hypothesis. Okay? Nakahanap ka, sabihin natin, ng theory. Then, gusto mo siyang i-apply kung really applicable pa siya at this certain time frame. Okay? Observan mo na siya. And you would now create your own hypothesis. Okay? Based doon sa first and second natin. Okay? In order for us to prove whether or not that this theory is really a thing, dito na natin susubukan to test and gather information to test yung prediction from your hypos or yung hypothesis. Okay? Ibig sabihin ng hypothesis, it is an educated guess. We do have some backups. Meron tayong mga subtopics in order for us to prove the main thesis statement. Si third naman, gusto natin i-test yung paniniwala natin. Okay? After we test, we gather some information. Lastly, we would refine the theory itself. Doon nang galing sa may general idea. Okay? We would like to synthesize. Gusto na natin i-polish yung gem or yung jewel. Gusto na natin siyang ipakinisin. It's either we would create another magpa-pop up ng panibagong tanong or we could debunk it. Diba? Debunk and say na ito ay may contradiction dun sa main general idea. Okay? Diyan lang nakakatalo sa last ngayon refining the theory. It's either mako-correlate or mako-contradict. Ayan yung scientific method natin. Next, ano nga ba ang theory? Theory is a logical interconnected proposition explaining how phenomenons are related. Well, in criminological say, it is an interdisciplinary approach wherein, sa madaling salita, kinikilala natin ang crime as a general idea na kaugnay na iba pang sangay under sociology. Okay? So sinasabi nga dito na ang lahat ng bagay daw ay magkaugnay. Diba? Yan ang sinasabi sa crime. Crime would be related, sabihin natin, through economics. Crime could be related to politics. Crime could be connected with anthropology. Okay? Yan yung sinasabi kasi nila doon, lalo na under umbrella, that crime is an interconnected idea with other proposition. It would be logical in a sense, kailangan nyo ma-review on how arguments work. Yung thesis statement natin should, and yung premises natin should work in line with the thesis statement. Ganon din yun. Diba? May gusto tayong i-propose, dapat yung proposal natin is yung mga objectives na 1 and 2 na premises natin, it is in line with your thesis statement. Ganon nagiging logical. Okay? Logical explanation of the phenomena, ayan, corresponds, relevant, ulitin ko, relevant empirical facts, practical guidance for future researchers, okay? Pag ang theory natin, hindi siya na-explain, na-describe, I think it's quite useless for it to call us a theory. Diba? Theory per se would be things that we could describe and the ability of us to explain the theorem behind that or the explanation behind that. Okay, kailangan natin ma-explain. Kung hindi siya na-explain yung mga certain concept, I think it would be irrelevant for it to call us a theory. Okay? And that's for me. Okay? Kailangan kasi makita natin dito yung relevant empirical facts wherein yung mga kinakailangan na mga premises natin would support our main thesis argument. Okay? Yung main point of view natin. Kailangan na nababack up siya. Okay? And sometimes, syempre, theories are shared. Nasi-share yan to other future researchers wherein pwede kasi nilang magamit yung theory or na general theory na discover natin at the moment to future researches. Okay? Kasi that's how theories are developed through multiple applications. Okay? Then sinasabi natin na ang existing criminological theory, it's either it could be debunked, okay, masabi natin contradicting, may mali, or it could be improved, or pwede kami madagdag doon sa panibagong theory. Okay? Through the process of testing. Okay? Yan yung theory natin. So, theories per se would be a logical interconnected proposition. Ibig sabihin, you have a thesis statement backed up with your datas. And your datas have questions that also interconnected pa rin dun sa ating main argument or main thesis statement natin. Okay? So, theories should be clearly and explicitly can be described, nade-describe siya, nasasabi natin, and we could also explain it behind those concepts. Okay? Yan ang sinasabi dito in our theory. Okay? Next would be theory construction. Okay, ano ba tong ating theory construction? Madali lang naman yung theory construction natin. So, in order for us to construct a formulation of a theory, construction formulation of a theory, una kasi nagsisimula sa causal relationship. Okay? It is a dependent independent variable. So, I presume that you have already taken your own research classes on the earlier part before watching this one. Causal relationship in a sense na cause and effect. Yung ating effect or yung ating independent na variable, di ba? Mayroong mga causes na dependent variable. Ibig sabihin, kumari is ang main natin na point. For example, in crime would be, let's say, yung increasing number of theft sa isang lugar. Okay, what are the causes? Diba, ang causes natin dito, it could be siguro kulang ng police visibility. And then that one, prevention, sabihin natin, yung lugar nagkakaroon ng mga graffitis and all, and mukhang hindi naaalagaan yung lugar, kaya nataas yung number of theft. Well, then again, it could be number of ways for us to understand the causes behind the causes and the effects, okay? Kailangan natin kasi mabigyan ng relationship yung dalawang yan. Okay? Lalo na sa increased number of theft. Masyadong general siya, no? Kung gusto mo mag-focus sa few points in causal, diba? Kailangan ilagay mo rin kung saan yung lugar mismo. Okay, diba? Doon mo na siya madadigest. Doon mo na siya ma-analyze and to synthesize at the end. Next would be after knowing the causal relationship, the cause and effect, alamin natin yung definition of concepts. Katulad nga sinabi natin kanina in theory, if your concepts cannot be defined, it couldn't be explained well too. Okay? Kasi kailangan mo muna siyang malaman kung ano to para malaman mo rin kasunod kung para saan to. Ganon din yon. Kung hindi mo alam kung itong bagay na to, what's the use, di ba? Ibig sabihin nun, hindi mo rin alam kung para saan ginagamit to, kung paano ba siya iuugnay to other concepts. Okay? Next would be concept by concept, i-interconnect mo siya, ibibigyan mo siya ng relationship. Kasi nga sinasabi natin dito that in criminological research, it is interdisciplinary approach wherein malalagyan mo siya ng webbings, kaya malalagyan mo siya ng chains from concept to another concept. Okay? Pagsasabahin mo, isi-synthesize mo. Mabibigyan mo siya ng another general idea. Okay? Next would be theoretical concept. This is subjected to testing of the variables. Ibig sabihin ng variables natin, it variates. Ibig sabihin, pwedeng tumaas, pwedeng bumaba. If you administer this one, o kaya mag-introduce ka ng this one, magbabago kaya yung result, o kaya yung numbers or yung result dito sa ating first variable or second variable. Okay? Gusto nating subukan yung isang concept na to. Kung ano yung mga changes. Diba? Kung aangat or bababa. Diba? Then, i-explain ulit natin. We would define its concept pa rin. Okay? Yan yung theoretical concept natin. Next is hypothesis testing. Kasi in the first part, we would have our own hypos or educated guesses. Diba? Bago tayo mag-start. Meron na tayo naka-inculcate na purpose wherein ginawa natin ng parang ending kaagad yung kwento. Okay? In a hypothesis testing, gusto natin malaman kung yung ending na nasa isip nga naman talaga natin is the same sa mismong application na nitong ating theory or yung ating mga variables. Okay? Sa ating pag-gather ng information. Okay? Via scientific method. Alam naman na natin kung ano ang scientific method. Sunod is yung data analysis. Siyempre, yung data analysis natin is for us to test yung variables and to show if it's complementary, nag-work nga ba talaga siya or not contradictory. Okay? Yung iniisip mo bang ending, ganun ba talaga ang nangyari? Or iba yung nangyari? Okay? Diyan na nangyari sa data analysis. And every end ng data analysis natin, nagkakaroon ng generalization. Kaya nagkakaroon ulit ng synthesis. Yung mga pinagbukod-bukod natin ng una, pagsasamahin natin sila ulit as a whole. Okay? So that's generalization. In generalization, we're gonna create a new theory behind that. Okay? And lastly, ito yung evaluation of theory. Evaluation of theory, this is the part wherein, ito nga, makikita na natin if a new problem would be there, kakaroon nga ba ng panibagong problema, or it would be as is. It would work katulad nung sa mga first theory natin. If it would complement or it would be contradictory. Okay? So I guess this would be the end of the first part. I'll cut this because medyo siya mahaba. Okay? Another explanation or another part in the introduction ng theories natin, criminological theory, will be discussed in the next part. Okay? So again, thank you very much for reaching this end of this online lecture series. So again, abangan yung kasunod na ating part in this one. Okay, so thank you very much and have a good one sa lahat. Have a good day.